My name is Comrade Mamodu Muniru Daniel, a student of University of Lagos Political Science Department, and I'm an aspirant for the position of the NANCE president in the forthcoming NANCE National Convention in Abuja. Personally, I believe there are issues as regarding the student movement in Nigeria, because if you look at it from the past, you have to agree with me that the glory days of student movement in Nigeria is gone. Take for example, if you look at in 1978, when you had students come together to, you know, make demands from the government, even the military government, where the likes of Shegu Okonkwo, the leader of the then National Union of Nigerian Students, you know, led students in a mass protest demanding for, you know, a change of a government policy which the students felt was obnoxious. But today, coming to democracy, where there is even freedom of expression, you know, people believe so much that the student movement has not done more. And for somebody like me, it is beyond, we cannot just keep criticizing. We need to also go and, you know, make effects that change we feel is required among this within the student movement. Now, the relevance of NANCE cannot be overemphasized, in the sense that we can look at the current case of rape allegation that led to murder of Ms. Vera in Edo State. The NANCE president recruited the secretariat and added pressure to your existing pressure that the police must ensure that they fish out the culprits, which as it stands, the commissioner of police have also assured Nigerian students that they will ensure they get justice. Going to Oyo State, Ibadan, the NANCE president has had two few days was there to also tell the whole world that they are not sleeping. So you cannot actually over beyond that. Issues on campus, you still see NANCE president going to campus for intervention. So I've not said that the NANCE president has not been embarking on intervention, but all I'm saying is most times people in maybe far northeast don't feel the pressure, don't feel the impact rather of NANCE president. You only see more of maybe southwest, north central, in Abuja, Lagos. But if you go to every campus, there are issues, genuine issues NANCE is supposed to address, which is the basis of the formation of NANCE after NUNS was prescribed in 1979 by the Obasanjo administration. NANCE came on board. They came because of these issues must be addressed. The welfare of students should be a pivotal issue that NANCE should look at. But of course, in recent times, there have been loud complaints that people just get into NANCE to empower themselves. So I am coming to say that, I'm pledging to say, if I become NANCE president, these issues of genuine struggle will have it back. I'm a student of University of Lagos, MSc Political Science. I did my BSc at the Obafemi Awolowo University, Ile-Ife, when I was National Secretary of NANCE. And I can tell you vividly that the requirement to contest for NANCE presidency is when you are a valid student on campus. And I'm a valid student, of course, the records are there to check. Beyond that, there have been this outcry that why can't a young, normal undergraduate student be NANCE president? If you have to be sincere with ourselves, I don't see how a young undergraduate who has just gained admission to campus, maybe 200 or 300 level, will travel to 36 states to campaign for votes. You must have a flexible curriculum to do that. So that is one of the major challenges that students are facing. Two, like I said, so many students are not even aware of NANCE. So how do they participate? Three, it is capital intensive. Moving to 32 states, it tells you you have to look for transportation, accommodation, feeding. These are challenges that I feel a common student, or an average student rather, quote unquote, might not be able to afford. So, but there's nothing stopping any student from vying for NANCE presidency or any other elective offices. As long as you are a student, you are eligible to contest. There's what we are working on at level of University of Lagos. It's called Nigerian Student Interaction App. The world has gone digital. And most times, something might happen in Katsina, and the NANCE president may be in Abuja or in Nasarawa, where his campus is, might not know. For me, traveling to states like Borno, Yobe, I visited all the campuses there. I can tell you automatically the challenges of students in these states. And to be fair with the NAS president, he might not know, because I think there's a communication lacuna between the NAS national executive, zonal structures, state structures, and even the union president. So I think building that kind of Nigerian Student Interaction app will kind of strengthen that communication, whereby a student on campus can just stay on at the level, at the comfort of his room. He just gets on the app, he makes his complaint, the national secretary gets, you know of it, and they act. And it also helped to be on record, because most of the complaints I also got from students is that most times when they are genuine issues, they call NAS executive. The NAS executive goes to the campus, maybe to their oppressor, quote unquote, and they allege that most times when they give them money, they betray the struggle. So I and of course things like this might not really have proof. So when we go digital, like I plan something we can do, it also helps for record sake. Of course, with the COVID-19 reality, it's obvious that education in Nigeria generally, you know, as it would not suffice the challenges that will arise. Most companies, even in abroad, when you check, most of them now believe that people can work from home. And one of the realities of this COVID-19 period is, even when people stayed back at home, the employers of labor have now discovered that most of the labor force is not required, so they have to cut. It's a reality that will happen, whether the government try to stop it now, but reality we'll see. So what some of us were now thinking is, the people should create a curriculum whereby, as you are schooling, you are also working. There's nothing wrong with a student schooling in school and also learning mechanic. Tomorrow, I mean, if we can have such ideas, we can still have maybe NGOs or maybe government policy that also help set up students if they can actually learn these skills and they feel they can continue. We cannot gainsay the fact that NANS, some people call NANS a political party, you know, but why NANS is not a political party, my own opinion is that there is no one political party that can argue that have control of NANS. Different states, you know, you see politicians actually going to influence who becomes, you know, NANS executive or zonal in at different levels. And one of the strength advantage I have, of course, even at this level, there are rumors of other candidates being sponsored by state governors, which of course we heard here and there. But as it is right now, I can tell you categorically that nobody, no politician, has ever given me a dime to say contest for NAS president, because as I've been campaigning, of course, my campaign has been clear. This is a pro-student aspiration, and I want students to hold me on that. Because after NAS, of course, if I do badly as a NAS president, of course, history is there to either vilify or vindicate me. If we begin to look back into the basis of NAS, I can tell categorically NAS today is a reflection of the challenges of the general society, which is Nigeria. Once the head is bad, the body is also bad. So I think NAS is not just the challenge we face in NAS is not a product of students, but the challenge of the general society where poverty has been used as a weapon to control people. So once you have not eaten, the first thing that comes to your mind when you have power is, what do I get? So in the case you have defeated poverty, if we have a situation whereby students feel after graduation there is work, I mean, we won't have much people saying I want to be NAS president. And for some of us, one of the idea, one of the goals we want to set in NAS is, by the time we make NAS popular, which I promise that, of course, NAS, there's no doubt about that, NAS will be popular, students will begin to, you know, gain that impression of demanding for more. This is what I want. Okay, if you think you can do that, why not come and contest in NAS? Well, most times I try to concentrate more on my ideas, because right now, like I said, I've traveled to over 32 states, and I communicate with the non-president on a daily basis. We talk to the non-president from different axes on a daily basis. We engage stakeholders, because, of course, the stakeholders too are there, who has been sustaining the organization over time. So most of the time I pay attention to my aspiration. And I can tell you, if you go by campaigns who has been on campus, there is nobody, I stand to be corrected, no aspirant that I know has gone as far as Bronu, gone as far as Yobe, Gashua, Potiskum, you know, Damaturu, to campaign to the genuine student union president, who I keep close communication with. Nobody has done that. In terms of, you know, what I bring on the table, in terms of intellectual, you know, capacity, I think I still stand, you know, head above every other contestant, because I'm a product of Great Ife, and I'm doing my MSc in UNILAC political science. And before I even gone into unionism, I have first settled the issue of my academic performance is there. So I still want to say that perhaps the way we can prove this is, and I challenge any other aspirant to engage us in terms of ideas and what you have. And I can tell you the result before now, that it will be head over every other aspirant.